is the exact figure, which is close to 4% as well, right? So how much dollars are needed at the end of 1 year? So if peso appreciates 4%, so we would be converting our dollar not on 0.1, converting our dollar on 0.1038835 or 0.104, right? So simple, you just multiply it with the 20 million. So now at the end of 1 year, they would be needing 2,077,710 dollars. Right, guys? So this is the real implications of purchasing power parity, right? So we can guess that. Okay, now the real question start here for your businesses, or for if you are working in a company or in a finance company, or if some clients come and ask you, you know, we want to plan to import, so you can give them a good guidance or good recommendations that, look, every country announces its expected inflation for the year. Every country, and it's written on their financial pages and all the stuff. Real data is also coming, but their expectations also coming. Economists, good analysts, financial analysts, they predict all these situations. So you can just paste those predictions here in the formula and you can guess that, okay, in 1 year, currency is going to be appreciate. And if you are importing this material and you say that, okay, maybe you kept 2,050,000 and you said that, okay, I want to buy 20 million and I have kept aside $2.05 million to convert it to 20 million Mexican peso. So you are in vulnerable state. Why? Because the foreign exchange rate gonna rise and you would be needing extra amount on the top of your 2.05 million. So in order to save your day, in order to save that trouble of shortage of money, if you are owning your own business, you would go to forward or futures, or you can guide your client that, okay, this is not enough. You need to do either go for derivatives or options, or either you go for future and forward to save exchange rate risk, right? This is how the investment world, investment companies, investment clients, exports and import, you know, facilitating consultants, they work. And this is a real knowledge, right? You can really apply to your own business as well. If you have a plan to support your family business, your brother business, your friend's business, or your own business, these things really matters, right? Let's move forward. So using PPP to estimate exchange rate effects. So the relative form of PPP can be used to estimate how exchange rate will change in response to the differential in inflations. So international trade is a mechanism by which inflation differential affects the exchange rate according to this theory. Here we go. If you have relative high local inflation, so your currency will go down. When your currency will go down, your products look cheaper to the outside world, your exports start rising. Oh, relatively high local inflation, imports will increase, exports will decrease. Local currency should depreciate, yes, by the same degree as inflation differential. That's amazing. Let me. Relatively high local inflation. High local inflation means local currency will depreciate. The so what happened to here? Or I'm misunderstanding it. High local inflation. Local currency should depreciate. Well done. When local currency will depreciate, its exports gonna rise, not the imports. Wow. So I think we need to see this scenario one more time. So for this time, just ignore this one and let's move forward. I would be discussing this in our next class, or I would be explaining it in our WeChat group. What goes wrong here with this picture? Okay, now co-founding effect. So we are just basing on purchasing power parity. We are betting, or we are saying that the foreign exchange rate will increase or decrease based on just inflation. So recall our previous discussion that 4% Mexican dollar will increase, but in reality, it just increased 2%. Why? Because in purchasing power parity, we are just seeing inflation, but the mechanism or determinants of exchange rates are inflation, interest, income, government expenditures, and expectations. Other factors are also there, right? So a change in a country's spot rate driven by more than inflation differential between two countries. It's not just on inflation. It also depends on interest rate, also depends on income, also depends on the government expenditure or government controls, sorry, government controls, and also expectations about the future. So we are just betting on the one basis, which is in inflation. So if currency is not appreciating according to you 4%, then other factors do have a major role to play. So let's talk about the example here for co-founding effects. Assume that Switzerland inflation rate is 3% above the US inflation. It means in Switzerland, inflation is high, 3% more than the US. So according to the fundamentals of purchasing power parity, Switzerland currency should depreciate and US inflation should appreciate. Sorry, US dollar should appreciate, right? So from this information, PPP theory would suggest that Swiss franc should depreciate by 3% against the dollar. Yet if the government of Switzerland imposes trade barriers against US exports, right? So Switzerland currency will go down, right? For 3%. So what if, the government, imposes trade barriers? So what will happen? Goods are not moving out and coming inside the countries. So that effect, 3%, we will not see in the market, as due to the intervention of the government, the results are not that the Swiss franc depreciate 3%, right? So Switzerland's consumer and firms will not be able to adjust their spending in reaction to the inflation differential. Therefore, exchange rate will not adjust as suggested by PPP, right? Plus, the second cause in which PPP does not hold, and that is no substitute for traded goods. What if the value of your local currency still, goes or still goes down, and you have no other choice, or you don't have that product locally available? So then you have no other option to buy from. Even at a higher cost, you still importing. So right now you are seeing this kind of stuff in world economy. So everything was previously dependent on Chinese, and now Chinese trade stops. Now prices are start rising. Even then, we don't have any other substitute. So we are left vulnerable with the Chinese trade. So when Chinese are supplying the market, they will supply at a higher price. So you are exploited. You will pay higher prices. So most of the things now occurred in the iPhone prices, mobile phones, computer prices, or computers, gadgets, or if you want to repair the computers, the motherboard, and all those stuff. So the prices are skyrocketing right now. Even the mobile phone screens, their prices are skyrocketing. Why? Because there is no substitute available for that one. So if goods are not available domestically, consumer may not stop buying imported goods, right? So reconsider the previous example here. If the US consumer do not find suitable substitute goods at home, they may continue to buy high priced goods from Switzerland, and the Swiss franc may not depreciate as according to the PPP, right? So international future effect. Okay, let's take a 10 minutes break, and then we try to, you know, encompass the international future effect. So let's just digest the interest rate parity and the purchasing power parity. So what does interest rate parity tells us? That if you want to exploit the interest rate, you cannot exploit. Why? Because the higher country, the higher interest rate over there, which country which is having higher interest rate, its forward premium will go up. And then we ended up earning according to our local interest rate. That's it. Whether we earn 10% over there when we convert back into home country's currency, we ended up earning 5%, right? Which is according to our local market interest rate. The purchasing power parity, it says that whether you buy from US or buy from your home countries, the cost is the same. Why? Because exchange rate adjusts according to the inflation. So whichever country has highest inflation, its currency go down, foreign currency will go up. So that's now what we have studied till now. Let's take a 10 minutes break and then we start from here. Hello class, and welcome back after a short break. Okay, so let's continue from where we had got some trouble, and we step aside from the scenario from here. That what happened if local inflation is high? So immediate effect is that, why? What is the effect of inflation? People have too much money. When people have money, they will import more, right? And export decreases. So what happened due to this relatively high inflation? We import more, and what happened after that? Our currency starting depreciating. Okay, so similarly with this scenario two, if we relatively have a low inflation, what will happen? People have less money. So what will happen? So they will export more exports. So current account, you know, deficit, or the trade balance is like that. They will import less. They will import less imported goods, and their exports will increase, which do have a pressure on the currency appreciation. So local currency start appreciating if it is having low inflation, right? So that scenario, we got some kind of like trouble, or we just couldn't match the pace and got distracted. So I just want to clear that point here. Okay, so international Fisher effect. So recall from our chapter 4, in which we talk about that high interest rate means stronger demand for local currency. So what we have discussed up till now, that country who got higher interest rate, right, its currency should appreciate, right? But international Fisher effect is opposite to that theory. It says the interest rates affect the exchange rate, how? And it mixes the interest rate parity and the purchasing power parity together. So they say that interest rate they are nominal, and nominal interest rate is equal to risk-free rate plus